All right, so we had a little mini brouhaha that erupted online yesterday. AOC tweeting out a link to some new pieces, sweatshirts or whatever, that she designed on her website. Some say don't drink water and don't be racist. What about the Green New Deal? One says tax the rich. Now look, do I think that the drink water one is dumb? Yeah. Do I think that a lot of progressivism, a lifestyle brand? Yes. But the attacks on this are so stupid. Let's throw Ben Shapiro's thing up there. Ben Shapiro's like, well, it's capitalism to sell something, you know, at a price of $58. And Dean Browning, I don't even know who the hell that is, but let's throw that up there. Same thing, he's like, hey, AOC is practicing capitalism. I mean, this has got to be the dumbest conversation, Ryan, that the American people have been subjected to in a long time. And just explain what why exactly this sweatshirt costs so much.
Right, I mean, on the one hand, people sell merch to raise money for their campaigns. Like the more markup you have on your merch, the more money you're making for your campaign.
Yes.
And the reason that people buy merch generally from people is so that they can support them. It's not because they need one more tote bag or they need one more sweatshirt or one more t-shirt that they might not wear until they just give it away to a thrift store. But the other point is that there is a cost to producing these things. And if you produce your merch in China or somewhere else in Southeast Asia or some other places in the world, you can get your products at like 50 cents per unit shipped over here. If you use union labor here in the United States and source everything from here, it's going to cost you more money,
right?
Because of the last 40 years of not having an industrial policy, unless you call the industrial policy selling our fundamental industrial manufacturing base to China and elsewhere around the world. We've sold off all the pieces that would allow somebody like AOC to make something in the United States and sell it for that cheap. The only way to do that is through a centralized kind of industrial policy that organize your manufacturing capacity as Hamilton argued for 250
years.
In the meantime, you're going to have to pay more if you don't want your kind of MAGA hat to say made in China.
Yeah, exactly. I thought that's what we were all about now. No, this is the truth, which is about dumb dunking contest for no reason. Let me throw her response up here. And look, you guys know I don't like AOC, but she's like, I'm freaking out. And she's like, what's the difference between ours is made in the U.S., it's made in the United States, it's made by union labor. These are things we support. These are things that we're supposed to do. If somebody wants to pay $58 for it, go for it. That's also capitalism, by the way, right? It's like, isn't this something that we generally support? And it just makes me so mad. Is there a substantive critique to be made? Drink water and don't be racist? That's stupid, okay? Like, that's progressive. That's just like wine moms running around, jogging in the Upper West Side being like, look at me, I'm so cool and I'm not racist. Is that annoying, vapid, and bad for our politics? Yeah, I think so. But that's not the critique that they're leveling here. And look, maybe you disagree and that's fine. But again, it's the lowbrow level to which they stoop in order to attack her is just so dumb and obviously empowers her position, especially whenever she's like, yeah, I made my stuff here in the United States with union jobs, something you pretend to support or at least said you supported. And it just makes it even dumber. I think it makes all of us dumber.
They've created this whole alternative reality where Ocasio-Cortez is an idiot.
Yeah,
like she's replaced kind of the old dumb blonde in a lot of the jokes that they tell. And yet when they come at her, they always come with the most idiotic arguments this is capitalism. Well, OK, fine. Yeah, we're a capitalist society. This is money changing hands. They actually do have currency in socialist countries, believe it or not. And more to the point, it's not the free market. Like she's not trying to enter the kind of T-shirt business, the T-shirt distribution business. She's not saying I have the best deal on drink water and don't be racist T-shirts in the whole country. And, if you buy two, you get a third half off and become a member. And she's not buying like Facebook ads that will try to get you on a dollar a month Razor Club. So this is not her market play. This is part of her activism and her organizing. As she says in that response, she's trying to fund her grassroots organizing. In other words, she's trying to raise money for her campaign. People are happy to give her money and get nothing in return. That's what a political, you know, that's what a $25, $50 political contribution is about. You know, if you want to get a little bit more money from those people, what you start doing, and The Intercept does it, Rising does it too. I'm pretty sure.
Like does every, it, right?
And NPR does it, because once you're a monthly member, you give people a sticker, then cool. I need an Intercept sticker for my laptop. All right, I'll do another $10.
Right.
And like you said, it is a way to kind of emote your values. So people can walk around town with their Don't Be Racist shirt. They can wear their Intercept hoodie and they can show, look, I'm somebody who supports this type of thing. The New Yorker tote, the NPR tote, all of these are cultural signifiers, and people that say, I paid money for this. And so, of course, you're going to pay more money, because then you get to, shout a little louder with your cultural signifier.
Right. And look, that's America. That's fine. You know, it's pretty annoying whenever I have to walk down the street in D.C. and see all these dudes with friend of the pod things when I'm like, oh, God, all these stupid Pod Save America bros. But hey,
you've been warned.
Yeah, so but I've been also, warned. I'm like, stay away from these folks. That's right. And so, look, and I can walk around. I wear whatever shirts I want. It's a free country. Everybody just at least be smarter about it. Anyway, we'll have more Rising for you right after this.